Yeah, me as well. This cat's happy today. Where's my meow? Puss, puss, puss. You gotta kiss people, huh? You gotta give people a nose kiss on the YouTube, huh? You little cat. Puss, puss. You gonna meow? Puss, puss, puss. They'll often make you meow. Ooh, massage. Massage, hey? Eh? You like it, don't you? It's a shit stare on your cat. He'd love those little massages. At least he meowed for you. Puss, puss, puss. Puss, puss. Puss, puss, puss. Puss, puss. Come here. Yeah, yeah. Come on. Yeah. You sneaky little bugger. Get some more stuff on here. And they got it to wire it all up. And yeah. There we are. Hey cat. So this is my audio input. I'm gonna dig out some shielded cables from a TV circuit board that the AV wires go onto. Rear projection TVs are good for things like that. They're a gold mine for parts, but they're fading away very quickly. The tip's getting them by the bucket load, so destined to be burnt in an incinerator in China, so no chance of hell of getting any more parts like that anymore. So I got some, should have some left in my stock. I think I got a couple of shielded AV audio leads from that sort of situation in my stock, I hope. I could probably just get away with using this, but I want to get a proper AV cable with the sockets, because it's got all the channels, both channels, just only got two positives for the audio, and the grounds for the input will just go to one of these wires. So these are the speakers, left, right. My audio input, speakers out, power in, go on here. So two positives for the audio left and right channel, and the grounds are all just going straight to common. So any of this ground or the ground on the heatsink, yeah, they all share the same ground on this board. So yeah, do it properly. I'm gonna get a nice bit of wood from somewhere, bolt down some standoffs on a bit of wood. And have a light little board in the front of it where I can just plug the AV leads into. I may do that, but I'll just do it for test purposes and I'll eventually get a Bluetooth module. Smells vintage. LIC must be the brand. Fourth week of 1978. Dual audio amp board. Thinking of that, I don't think it would be stereophonic. I think it just predates that. I think stereophonic was in the 60s. They had just established it in the 60s, I think. Some actual bloody record players and consoles would start to introduce stereophonic sound. It didn't really become high fidelity until the 80s, so this is not going to be a high fidelity amplifier by any means, but it'd be a... And it's an early stereophonic, or stereo as we call it nowadays, amplifier. So be very careful of these earlier circuit boards. This trace has come off easily. This is just age related, it's already shriveled. This is from age. Very good quality stuff. Nice retro circuit board. Motorola components. This is before Philips brought Motorola out. I've seen some Motorola components even in J-Car kits, near old stock. I think Philips bought Motorola's components business set in the mid-90s, I think it was. So none of these components get too hot. This thing runs happily, very happily, so. Hook up this thing to two speakers and do some tests of this input cable. I get like a lower, deep, more powerful sound out of one channel, this one. This is more high-pitched, high-frequency, so I'm guessing one's acting as a tweeter for high-frequency. This is for the low-frequency bass side of the audio, from what I can see. Although the both sides of the components look like they're the same, so they should be the same sound for each of the channels. I'll give it a go. I think I might have to check these capacitors. See if they're still good. the components are, and the values are the same, so I don't see why it wouldn't be half high frequency or low frequency. I know that was common in old car radios in the 70s, like the Corolla. It had the left for the low frequency bass and the other right speaker for the high frequency audio. 10k trim pots, I'll leave those turned flat out. I just use the input and adjust the volume. I played with this, I don't know what that really does. Switches between that pin there, which isn't doing anything. I haven't got it connected to anything. It's pin, so that's pin 6. Pin 6 goes to that switch and switches the ground of this resistor. There. That big B trace here goes here and grounds to this one of the speakers here. Go on the ground here. This is all one trace, so it's going there. In the case of the diode, so I thought it was a power input, but turns it off. But no, it doesn't do anything. Could be just a way of wired it up differently though. Now let's give it another test. I'm going to use my Kinto amp as protective again. Until I can get the proper sockets for this thing, I can use it properly. Just plug the phone straight into it, but I won't do it just yet. It's worked out quite well, this little amp. It's the Ice Age proper, not the Remix one there. The way I've got this hooked up sounds like crap, but it works. Distortionic. Yeah, I think my assumption's right. One channel set up more for one channel's louder than the other. That's working, this one's working. I'll have to get my proper connection leads up on this thing. Put a proper AV input shielded wires in it. Put a proper input jack on this thing instead of just using this. Yeah, this is causing distortion how I'm doing this. Works though, both channels. Nothing getting too hot. Gee, that's great. I could turn that channel off, but it's not so bad. Gee, look at that. Turn that channel down. And everything. Yeah, this thing's bridged somewhere. Yeah, that's how this thing's set up. I've got to check these old components, make sure those capacitors and everything are still good, to be sure. Yeah, that's how I got it hooked up. That's why this channel's working, but it's not very good. Yeah, better now. Minimal distortion on it, shut up, it's not very loud. Yeah, distortion. I hadn't known that quite bloody stereo that did that. Man, that is some of my early videos, that frying claptronics to earth, which is a circuit board out of that stereo. It did this thing flat out. That's the sort of distortion it was doing flat out. Tried solder joints, tried everything, it just wouldn't stop it. Because we'd tap it and it would go good again. But I couldn't find any dry joints in it. Yeah, happy, they're not getting too hot. Working good there. Interesting how this thing's been set up and arranged. Yeah. Needs a bit of work, but it works okay. Sounds better. Yeah. Sarah had this thing hooked up. It's got a bit warmer too. Way warmer. So it's kind of complex that I've got this thing set up. Maybe it's Yeah, maybe it's not exactly in stereo mode then. Yeah, no damage done. Anyway, that'll be enough for now. Thanks for watching.